Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Place your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Hawks. This is the Hill Morning News. My name is Victor Solis.
And I'm Maria, and on to Miss Williams.
Good morning. Hey, Hawks. Hey, happy Monday. I hope that you attended Hawktorials for those of you that needed to catch up on some assignments. Seniors, remember, if you haven't gotten your cap and gown, you need to do that right away. If you do not get your cap and gown by December 13th, you may not get it. So it's not just a good idea, get it done. For those of you who haven't finished the FAFSA, go on and get that done as well. Credit recovery is over, so whatever you did is what you did, and if you didn't do it, sorry. 9th and 10th graders, the last time you were on a school campus, you were in the 7th and 8th grade. And we're getting kind of tired of seeing those 7th and 8th grade behaviors because, well, you're now 9th and 10th graders on a high school campus. Again, did you remember my cup? I'm sorry if my eyes are speaking for me right now, but the behaviors are tired. The drama, tired. The excuses, over them. Every class you do not pass, you need to repeat. The excuses don't matter anymore. You've had the first semester to get it together. Fall semester is over. We're now going into spring semester. Let me make it plain again. Every class you fail is a class you will need to repeat. Every class you pass is a class that makes you closer to graduation. You need 220 credits in order to graduate from high school. Let that sink in for a minute. I know for some of you, it's like, oh my goodness, because you know that you messed up your freshman year for the 10th graders and the first semester of your 10th grade year. For the freshmen, you just messed up your first semester of high school and all of those classes you failed, you failed. The teachers didn't fail you, your parents, the adult in your life didn't fail you, you failed yourself. So this semester, let's decide to be successful. Let's decide that instead of going to the restroom for 15, 20 minutes, you go to the restroom, do your business, and go back to class. Let's decide that if it's not your business, you stay out of it. Let's decide that rumor wheel that just keeps going through social media, that you stop it and not bring it on the campus. You're making Citrus look bad. That's not who we are. It's time for you to level up in a whole bunch of different areas. 9th and 10th grade, you have the first semester to get it together. Second semester, let's go. We're over the behavior. It's said with love, it's said with care, and it's said with concern. Because if you continue on this path of making those bad decisions when you know better, that's a problem. And we will have to do what we need to do in order to help you understand a little bit better. Have a great one. Enjoy your winter break. We have 4 more get-ups for those of you that are going to be with us until Friday. We're also doing a raffle. Every day you wear your holiday gear, Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, Christmas, come to your counselors, get a ticket. We're going to pull names on Friday. We have Amazon gift cards. We have food gift cards. We may even have grocery gift cards for those who want your own treats at the grocery store. But we want you to come back ready to go in January with a new mindset. That at Citrus, we soar above all of the pettiness and we keep it classy here. If you don't know what it means to be classy, we're going to help you get there. Have a great one, Citrus.
Hi, I'm Yesenia Moran, and today I'm going to be talking about the worst 5 Christmas gifts you can give someone this Christmas. Starting off with the first one, we have mugs. Secondly would be ugly Christmas socks. Third would be keychains. Fourth, we have picture frames. Lastly, we have Christmas letters. This has been Yesenia Moran with the worst Christmas gifts you can give someone this year. Merry Christmas, Hawks.
Good morning, Hawks. This is Madison Nama here with today's Christmas song, Silent Night. Silent Night is a classic Christmas carol that was first heard about 202 years ago by Austrian villagers attending Mass on Christmas Eve. The song was written to tell the story of Jesus' birth. The song was written by Joseph Moore. Many different people sing different versions of this song. Here is the Kelly Clarkson version. Classic peaceful Christmas song telling the story of Jesus' birth, which is celebrated on Christmas and is worth listening to if you have not already. Thank you, Hawks. Merry Christmas.
Good morning, Hawks. Mrs. Wiley here. Just some announcements from the guidance department on some upcoming dates that you need to be aware of. For seniors specifically, we have our financial aid application deadline for incentives coming up December 17th. So if you can please get your financial aid applications completed by that date so you can be entered into the drawing for some prizes. Also be invited to a barbecue in January. Mr. Johnston and ASB are going to be cooking up some food for you at early release lunch, but you've got to finish that financial aid on time in December 17th by that date. Also, there's some additional prizes and goodies that are going to be drawed off, and one of those is going to be some prom tickets. So huge incentives, so please, if you need help on your financial aid applications, come and see the guidance department. We have our college success coach available to help support. You can make appointments if you need to, as well as your counselors. So please come and get support and help on that. Also, for those people that are in credit recovery right now, the deadline's coming up really soon. I believe it's today. So make sure that you're finishing up all the work that you need to finish up and pass those classes so that you can get those credits. And then lastly, for those seniors that have finished college applications, please make sure that you are opening your emails and checking for emails from those colleges and opening up your college portals and following those directions on what those next steps are. If you need help with that, please come see your counselor. That's all for me. Have a great day.
Hey, CitrusO Hawks. I'm Alexis, and I'm going to tell you guys about a Hanukkah movie called Eight Crazy Nights. This movie is about a 33-year-old party animal named Davy Stone, who himself is in trouble with the law after his wild ways go too far. In keeping with the holiday spirit, the judge gives Davey one last chance at redemption. He spends the holiday doing community service as the assistant referee for the youth basketball team, or go to jail. He chooses the referee and thinks he goes off easy until he meets the elf-like head referee, Whitey Duvall. Thank you guys for watching. This has been your daily holiday movie. Bye.
Thank you guys for watching. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Maria.
And don't forget, get a lot of rest. It's finals week, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.